It was definitely natural for me to go to fantasy and science fiction as my genres of choice. I've always had a very big imagination, and I feel that fantasy is the genre that doesn't have any limits, which really works for me. You know, your imagination is the only boundary. So even though I think one day I might write historical fiction, that's the other place I would like to venture, but fantasy for now is definitely the place where I belong. Well, I suppose you can have classic fantasy as well, something like Tolkien, for example. But it allows me to portray the world in a slightly different way. I can reflect on history and real life, but I can do it through a sort of distorted mirror. So I can allow myself to have fun and be really creative and let my imagination roam, but I can still discuss things that happen in the real world and affect real life. So that's why I like fantasy. For example, I can use bits of history, but I don't have to be 100% faithful to history, and I really like that. Some of the historical elements that went into the world of Priory and the mythological elements, first of all, was the legend of St. George and the Dragon, which is very important in my country because St. George is the patron saint of England. And it's a story that I thought about a lot when I was young because I was raised in a Christian school, and St. George is a very important figure in kind of English Christianity. And it was a story I really wanted to retell because it is the ultimate story of the damsel in distress. It's always the woman being rescued from the dragon. She doesn't do anything, the knight always saves her. So that was the main story that I wanted to retell. But I also love that I could think about history, as I mentioned earlier. I like bringing historical elements into fantasy. So I used aspects of the 16th and 17th centuries, and basically, I asked myself, how would these historical events have happened in a fantasy world? And it meant that I could just think about them from a slightly different angle. So that was really fun. And I used a mix of real events and different myths and legends. Feminism was really one of the driving forces behind writing The Priory of the Orange Tree because of my relationship with the legend of St. George. So I really wanted to give the woman an active and powerful role. That was, in a way, the whole point of the retelling. So that was just a natural element of it, I suppose. And yeah, I wanted to write a fantasy book where I could see myself reflected. It's a story where that I would have liked to read when I was a little girl, because often I would see fantasies. You know, I grew up with The Lord of the Rings, for example. It's a wonderful fantasy, but very, very male heavy. And I just wanted to write a story where the women were, you know, at the center of the story. They were the heroes of their own quests. And it was natural to me as well to write queer relationships into it because, well, there's really no reason not to, I suppose. We live in a diverse world, queer people exist. I wanted to see that in fantasy stories. And it also helped me come to terms with my own sexuality as well. So it was it was an interesting journey. One of the things I wanted to do in The Priory of the Orange Tree as well was to show different types of female strength. So I think that a few years ago we were really talking about strong female characters, and I think that was great, but it was often women who were embodying what I might call traditionally masculine roles. So they had to be, you know, good at fighting and, you know, less emotional. And I wanted to show women like that. I wanted to show women who could use swords and who were warriors, but also women who were strong in different ways. Like, for example, the character of Queen Sabran, you know, her strength lies more in politics and in giving speeches. So that was something I wanted to explore as well.